first contestant, Henry Wu, with his speech title, The Road Less Traveled. The Road Less Traveled, Henry Wu.
Toastmasters and guests, how many of you think the Toastmaster journey is just like a bed of roses? Why is it the road less traveled? Because it depends on your role, whether you're a Toastmaster member, an exco member, area governor, division governor, district governor. As you go up higher the rung, the road becomes less and less traveled. That's what I meant, road traveled. Most of us become members of Toastmasters Club when we sign the application form to join Toastmasters International. That's where our journey begins. Is it because we were invited to a club by a friend of us, a Toastmaster friend? Did we join because we do some research on the internet and found a club nearby and convinced us to attend? Or is it because just out of curiosity and want to find out more, we attend the club meeting? There are various reasons for us to join the Toastmasters Club. For me, I joined Toastmasters journey in November 2002 and applied for membership with the Dee Utama Toastmasters Club. That's been 10 years now. And whether it's a bed of roses or not, I'll leave it to decide at the end of my speech. As you know, as a beginner in the Toastmasters Club, your first speech is the icebreaker. So I did my icebreaker speech in December 2002, and like most first timers, always exceed the time. Just the other day, last month, I was a timer for a fellow Toastmaster who delivered his first speech. As usual, as expected, I pressed on the green light, then the amber light, red light, and the speaker continued speaking. 1 week after that, I cannot press the bell. It was the privilege of the icebreaker, no need to press. He couldn't speak. 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes, still talking. The members' audience were very agitated, feeling uncomfortable. Some were really showing body language, some so strong like this. But the speaker just continued speaking nonchalantly. When I finished timing, when he finished speech, I timed it 11 minutes. 11 minutes. Well, that's pretty of an icebreaker speech. And then, of course, you want to take other roles as well, evaluation, general evaluator or speech. And I had moments of hilarious moments. There was one speaker who spoke about his life history. He wanted to tell us something about his personal part of the history. But he spoke so fast, he says, now I want to tell you about my private part. Personal part becomes private part. So that was quite a hilarious moment until he withdrew and said, no, what I meant is I want to tell you about the personal part of my history. And that's another thing that you enjoy when you come to Toastmasters. You invite people's speeches and they make some unintentional mistakes and just that you're not aware. Another thing was that very passionate encounter. This speaker was telling a story about some Chinese characters. And there were three Chinese characters in the story. They were named Along, Abeng, and Akao. There were no speech characters other than that. At the end of the speech, when the general director asked the encounter to how many speech characters all the speakers said, when it comes to this speaker, then he mentioned three R's. Along, Akao, and so when you over-focus on your duty, you must be able to see the wood and the trees. Not just you can't see the tree because of wood. So this is one thing you have to be aware of. Of course, from being a foreign Toastmaster, I proceed on, I achieved my ICC in 4 years later. And then the next route I took was become an exco member. SAA first, followed by secretary, followed by treasurer, or BPR, treasurer, and now BPE. And I also moved on to join another club. Second club is called the Metropolitan Bilingual Toastmasters Club because I want to improve my public speaking in Mandarin, which I went back to school at my age to study Mandarin. So the journey can be varied and diversified. You don't only take on one journey, one club, you can go to other club as well and expand your experience and your exposure. And there are other clubs you can join to, for example, the advanced community meeting for advanced, for people who at least achieve CC. Of course, the advanced club, you also have community characters. There's one evaluator who did not like the evaluation feedback, and he stood up and says, "You bunch of drunkards," because he couldn't take it, the evaluation. In the ACM meeting, there's no holds barred. They call a spade a spade. If you're no good, they tell you you're no good. So these are things that you have to watch out for as you go on your journey. And then I became AG. Funny thing, I did not become a president, but I was appointed AG for W8 back in 2009. And that was another journey again, which is trials and tribulations. As AG, it's definitely not a bed of roses. At times you want to tear your head out because you can't get response from the club ex-schools for certain things that you want them to do. So these are moments that you cherish, that you can depend on your seniors to guide you along the way. And those masters being what it is, to me, it is fraught with trials and tribulations. Changes are there. It's how you manage to meet those changes. You have to rely on your mentors, your seniors, your experienced toastmasters to guide you along the way. And this, the moment that they always prepared for. You know, in the movie Forrest Gump, have you heard, seen the movie Forrest Gump? Back in 1994, on the movie blockbuster. And the opening screen was holding a box of chocolates. Remember the scene, not?
Yeah.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. So to me, the Toastmaster journey is like a never-ending journey. You do not know what are you going to face, the challenges, the trials and tribulations. Is how you manage it. Back to you.